Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how to read 2D array, how to print elements of 2D array in matrix format on output screen, and how you can calculate sum of all the elements which are available in 2D array and to print that sum on output screen. So I will be implementing this program in C language. So before starting explanation, just one update: if you go to detail or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to C programming, so you can follow them. Now I am going to write the program step by step. So first I am going to tell you how you can read 2D array elements from user. So starting with main function, first of all you need to declare a 2D array. So here I am declaring a 2D array whose dimension is 3, 4. So 3 is number of rows and 4 is number of columns. Then I am declaring variable I, j, and one more variable, that is s, who will be having calculated sum. Now after this I am going to write a printf. So you can write this message: enter 3x4 matrix. Now to read 2D array, you require nested loop. So first loop will repeat number of row time, that is 3. And inside this loop, you need to apply one more loop that will repeat according to column value. So that is 4. And inside this loop, you can write a scanf and address of a of ij, right? So this way, with this nested loop formation, you will be able to read all the elements of 2D array. So let's say I am drawing this here, 3 rows, and here we have 4 columns. Now I am putting indexes. So if we see, first row indexes will be 00, 01, 02, and 03. Then 10, 11, 12, 13, 20, 21, 22, and 23. So this way we need to use these indexes so that we can store the values. So now I am going to repeat this loop so that you can understand how values will be stored. So first I will be starting from 0. Then control will be transferred to this loop. And if you are facing any problem to use these three statements without curly braces, so you can put them like this. So now it is more readable, but each statement is having only one statement under it. That's why I didn't use curly braces. But if you are facing any problem, you can use them. So I is starting from 0, then check the condition, it is true. Control will be transferred to this J loop. So when I is repeating one time, then J will repeat 4 times, because it is starting from 0 to and going to 3. So initially j will be 0. So here you can see address of aij is written. So it will be like this. The first number will go to a00 position. So that is this position. So at this position, the entered number will be stored. Then only j will be incremented to 1. So this time it will be A01. So next number that will be entered by user will be stored here. So this way J will be incremented again. So it will be 02 and then 03. So these two positions will be filled and 4 rotations of J are completed. Then I will be incremented. It will be incremented to 1 and J will again start from 0. So next time what will happen? Indexes will be this 10, 11, 12, 13. So 10 is this, 11 is this, 12 and 13. So this way whole 2D array will be having values provided by the user. So I hope you understood how this loop is working. Now I am going to implement a second section, that is printing. And inside that, printing section, I am also going to calculate the sum, right? So our requirement is we need to print the matrix in this format, right? So first I am using printf. So I am writing this matrix is, so it will be printed on our screen. Then again I am going to start nested loops. So here you can see first loop is repeating row times and second loop is repeating column times. Now here inside this loop, first I am performing addition operation. And after this, I am going to print this value with %d, then backslash t. So this backslash t is for tab. So it will print some space between two digits. Then I am closing this loop. So this loop will repeat four times. So it will add all the elements of first row as well as it will print all the elements of first row. Then after completion of this loop, I'm going to use one more printf, which will change the cursor position to new line. So after completion of this J loop, first row is printed. So now I want my cursor to be available at second row. So after completion of this loop, you can use this printf backslash n, and then you can complete this loop. And after completion of this loop, you can print calculated sum that is available in s variable, so you can print that, and then you can close your main function. So this way, this part is for reading, this part is for printing 2D array on output screen as well as calculating sum, and this printf is printing calculated sum on output screen. So this printf is outside all loops, because if we calculate a total sum of 2D arrays, so it will be only one value. So after completion of all loop cycle, we will be having that calculated sum. So we can print that with the help of this printf. So I already explained you the rotation. So now I hope you can understood this rotation as well, because it will be having a 0, 0, then 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3 positions in these two places. So first row elements will be added with this, and first row elements will be printed this with this printf statement. Then after completion of this loop, I will be incremented. So I will be having value as 1. Then for second row, it will repeat again. So all four elements of second row will be added, and along with them, they will be printed as well. So this way I explained you how you can read 2D array from user, how you can print that in form of matrix on output screen, and how you can print total calculated sum of that 2D array on output screen. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, so you can open my channel, go to playlist, or you can go to detail or description of this video, where you will be having links of various playlists attached. So if you want to follow programming related videos, so watch my video, those are available on YouTube. So I hope you understood whatever I explained. Thank you for watching this video.